I would be asking you the questions posted by our audience from time to time. Otherwise, so please begin. The stage is all yours.
शिवाली, बिफोर सॉरी टू इंटरप्ट, बिफोर बिगनिंग द प्रोग्राम, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट आवर एचओडी प्रोफेसर रफीक अहमद फॉर वेलकम एड्रेस ऑफ द स्पीकर्स. सर प्लीज.
थैंक यू डॉक्टर खादिम। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। ऑनरेबल स्पीकर प्रोफेसर सतीश कुमार सिंह, वाइस चेयर आईटीपीएलई यूपी सेक्शन, रिस्पेक्टेड डायरेक्टर बीबीडी एनआईटीएम प्रोफेसर भावेश कुमार चौहान, एचओडीज डीआई प्रोग्राम ऑर्गेनाइजर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर खादिम मोइन सिद्दीकी, फैकल्टीज आईटीपीएलई एग्जीक्यूटिव कमेटी मेंबर्स, चेयर श्रीकांत सिंह, वाइस चेयर मारुंदर त्रिपाठी, ट्रेजरार साक्षी प्रेम, सेक्रेटरी अनुशिका राय, ज्वाइंट सेक्रेटरी अविनाश गुप्ता, वेब मास्टर शिवाली प्रसाद एंड डियर पार्टिसिपेंट एंड स्टूडेंट, आई एम वेलकमिंग यू ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट बाबू बनारसीदास इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट लखनऊ, एज वेल एज आईटीपीएलई स्टूडेंट ब्रांच काउंसलर बीबीडी आईटीएम लखनऊ। माय सिंसियर थैंक्स टू डायरेक्टर सर बीबीडी आईटीएम प्रोफेसर भावेश कुमार चौहान सर फॉर हिज गाइडेंस एंड मोटिवेशन। It is my great pleasure and honor to welcome you all in this IEEE boot camp under SAT Membership Development and Leadership Training 2020. Again, especially I would like to extend a warm welcome to our eminent speaker, Professor Satish Kumar Singh, for accepting our invitation greatly for making the event successful. We are indeed grateful for your gracious presence. I am so happy to see you together here. I hope the program will be greatly successful. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, Srikant, over you. Please start the event.
Okay, thank you, sir.
I now invite Professor Satish Kumar Singh to please start with his speech.
So, first of all, a very good morning and thank you very much for inviting me for this interactive session with Professor Bhavesh. So, I could chance interacting with him in past also, and again, we are interacting together with you people. So I believe that this is as counseling session on the scope of STEM, focusing on startup ideas and other things. So it's fine, but mostly if you have some doubts, some queries, if we are talking in counseling session, which type of counseling? What are your aims and objectives? That should be very clear. Okay. So I request all of you, in fact, Srikant, if you have anything, any queries, then we can discuss. We can discuss on those things. But if we talk about IEEE, so IEEE, basically, the objective of IEEE is to include the wide spectrum of the people, starting from school going kids, school children, our undergraduate engineering students, science students, beginning from first year onwards, maybe first year, second year, third year, fourth year, even the outgoing students also. Means the students who are passing out from those UG degrees, maybe UG, maybe PG degrees as well. So how well those people should be connected and what are the benefits that those people can get out of this IEEE. That is important. That is important. So normally, here, after joining IEEE, there are many expectations that you should get this, you should get that. Normally, when I became the member of IEEE, so I never thought of getting any kind of benefit. I mean, nobody was there to give me anything until I tried. I tried means I could not get so much from IEEE, okay? But I could get the satisfaction level. Means wherever I wanted to grow, I could by using this platform of IEEE. It means nobody is going to help you. Nobody is going to give something monetary to you. You're not going to get any money out of it. But what you can get is your satisfaction. But satisfaction, not simple satisfaction. If some of you are willing to grow in the domain of some technical fields, maybe some research field, maybe higher studies, maybe some good companies, etc., then this IEEE network is very big. Okay, you can get the help of many people. Yes. You can get the help of this network and you can grow yourself as per your desire. But ultimately, who has to work? Only you have to work. Then only you can grow. Okay. What IEEE can provide? IEEE can provide you all sort of supports, technical supports. If you want any reference letter from some people who is well aware of your work, and somehow those people are related to IEEE, if those people are providing the reference letters, then your half of the job is done. Normally what happens, if you can secure a reference letter from any IEEE fellow, then believe that your reference letter is going to be recognized worldwide. Nobody used to deny that reference letter. And this reference letter may be for some job application. Normally in US and other countries, it happens. If you are having a strong reference letter, okay, then your chances are great of getting either job or some admissions, etc., etc. But normally, IEEE people provide the reference letter simply, okay, somebody is requesting you provide me reference letter, and those people will go, no, you're not going to reference letter in this case. Until they are very much, they used to assure that you have worked as per their expectation, not their expectations, as per the expectation of the society. So those expectations are very, very small expectations. Okay, but ultimately you have to work. You can get anything those things, parents and others. So this is a student, and you're willing to get some good jobs or some good admissions for higher studies, it will be must. Everywhere it is required. So what is there? People are very much aware of this thing, and they used to provide the recommendation letters to all those known people who are actually associated as volunteers or active IEEE members. Active IEEE members. And this really creates a difference. It means you get associated, you do some work in IEEE field of interest, and then try to secure a recommendation letter from some IEEE fellow. If you succeed, then I guarantee that your chances of getting either admission or higher studies, admission for higher studies or getting a job are doubled. So rest assured. But ultimately, you need to work. You are not going to admission later. Okay. So you can get this thing. You can get the help of IEEE for developing your CV itself. There are so many things. It means not only developing the CV, there are only service providers, you can download the templates and you can develop your CV. But the development of CV technically, which is very much relevant to any industry which you're targeting or higher studies which you're targeting, how to write the statement of purpose while going for getting the admissions in higher studies, etc., etc. Every that kind of help is available with IEEE. But ultimately, you have to explore. Nobody will come to you and, okay, this is, now you do this thing. Because you're not paying anybody to anybody for this help, actually. Okay, nobody will take a pain to tell you, okay, you do this, you do. Ultimately, you have to explore the IEEE website, and there are so many things. So you can develop your CV, not only develop, there is a full network of IEEE. You can post your desire that you're willing to do some sort of
The voice is not audible.
All right. So the audience, that was Dr. Satish Kumar Singh. I think there is some internet connection problem with him. So in the meanwhile, I'll invite our director, Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan, sir. Sir, we have some questions for you that some students have posted and they wanted to ask. So I'll begin with the question. The first one being, the scenario in today's world is that achievements at a young age are praised heavily, while those who are struggling to achieve their goals get disheartened and also immediately they are tagged as failures. Even taking a drop year seems like you are a step behind. So what advice would you like to give to students who feel this way?
Shivali, this question is targeted to whom? Honorable speaker?
No, sir, to you.
Sorry, actually I was discussing it. Actually here I would say that involvement in, thank you for this question, first of all, anyone who have raised this, but at the same time I would say that involvement in right kind of activities, looking for right kind of peers, right kind of ecosystem, where IEEE or such kind of forums really helps, I think it changes the whole, I would say it's a game changer. Because you find this struggle or such kind of, you know, pressure of these struggle only when you are not in a right kind of ambience or right kind of environment. So I personally believe that these kind of platform which gives you so many opportunity of various kind, which suits your talent, because your talent is diverse, and IEEE or such forums, they really understand that very well. And engagement in these activities along with your other co-curricular activities, I think creates positive vibes within you and also within different individuals. So I personally believe, even seeing my student days more than 2.5 decades back, that this is the game changer. So anyone who is still on the verge and thinking of whether I should join or not join, and keeps himself away from institutional activities or these different forums, whether co-curricular or extracurricular, and particularly I would appreciate more co-curricular, you find this struggle rather than stressful, bit more enjoyable, and it also adds to your confidence. And I'm not saying this because I am addressing this question or such kind of query on this platform of IEEE. Even otherwise, had this question been posed to me, and it has been posed in different forms in different years by different students, my answer has always been the same. So I think involvement in right kind of platforms or right kind of company, and using your, or you know, using or utilizing your energy in a right way, because in your age the energy is too much, of course, being young, and it needs to be dissipated through right channels. And once it is dissipated, I think it act as a catalyst for more energy. This is really a very interesting thing. That if you really engage yourself more, instead of feeling tired, you feel more energetic. And if you are dull, and if you are somehow dull because you are not getting enough opportunity, or you have not taken any initiative to be in such kind of company, you find more self more tired and rather more dull. So I think on all those students who are not yet members of any forums, I think I really call upon them. I think this is the best thing that you can do, the value addition to your personality or also in your technical skills, and make your this journey, which usually is called like a struggle, more interesting and enjoyable ride. Thank you very much. And thank you, Webmaster, for this opportunity. I hope I have answered this question.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for enlightening the students. Can somebody please confirm if Satish sir is online now?
Yes, I'm there.
Okay, sir. So the next question that we have for you is that how good is research as an option for career, and how is IEEE a very good platform for research-related persons?
So basically, there are two questions. And the first question is whether a student should be involved in research or not, if I could understand.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Means how good is the research, okay, as a career. So whether a student should be involved in research or not. And the second question is whether IEEE can help in this research ideas or not. So basically, these are two simple questions. So, taking up the first question. So, earlier what was thought, okay, you do some undergraduate, maybe science or maybe engineering and other things, and you used to get the jobs. Okay, you used to get the jobs. And what is research? What is research basically? The research is basically some sort of capability related to, I mean, some sort of analytical capability, okay, which you need to develop in yourself. So basically, inherently, all the students are students who are having this analytical capabilities are basically inherent researchers. But on paper, they have to come. On paper, they have to come. It means whatever knowledge they are going to create, basically earlier, simply getting the knowledge and using that knowledge, it was sufficient even in the industries. Okay, but now there is a paradigm shift. Only getting some sort of knowledge and skills and using it for some meaningful purpose is not sufficient. So what is this? What is research? Research is nothing but the knowledge creation. Knowledge creation. So that further this knowledge can be used by somebody else, and then further knowledge can be created. It means better and better and better knowledge creation in a. So this is basically research. Okay. It means now companies are not looking for only skilled people. These companies are looking for the people who are definitely skilled, but at the same time, if it is required to solve some new problems or some unknown problem, those people should be able to solve those problems. And that is possible only when you're having some sort of analytical capability or you're having some sort of research capability. So normally research used to provide analytical capability along with the depth in a particular dimension. If you have this thing, then this is a deadly combination. So now I tell this thing, research is very, very important even for undergraduate student. Okay. What is the basic difference between an ordinary college? Okay. I also used to call our institution as an ordinary institution with respect to the research which is going, I mean, which is being conducted by the students. Getting my point? It means why we are ordinary people, why our institutions are ordinary institutions. Because the best brain, which can think, which can realize the ideas, which can ideate, means getting some new ideas, everything, the lot which is best and which is having the best energy is actually not doing any sort of research activities in these institutions. Okay, I ask a simple question. If you get a chance to get the admission in IIIT Hyderabad and BVD NITM, what you will prefer? Whether you answer or not at this point of time, but I mean, I know very well that you will prefer to get the admissions in IIIT Hyderabad. Why? Because there is students are getting the package of 60 lakhs. Okay, I'm not criticizing any institution. Okay, but trying to develop the base. Okay, just take it in this way. And what ordinary institutions, students like our institution and your institution, people are getting slightly lower salaries. What is the reason behind it? Reason is simple. Reason is you yourself, means you, the students, not the faculty members, you, the students. Where we are interested, we are not interested in the research. We do project here and there. We try to get the shortcuts and pass out from these institutions. We are not ready. Okay, my words may be tough at this point of time, but unfortunately, this is the truth. Okay, this is the truth, means for our situation, we are responsible. But if you change the scenario a little bit, how the scenario can be changed? Out of 100 students from your batch, from each and every section, only 20 students are getting good publications in good reputed conferences and journals. What will be there? What will be there? All the intellectual lot is going to perceive, going to observe your intellectual capabilities. Intellectual capabilities. Then they used to recognize. Okay. Then companies used to recognize how many good papers, how many good citations. Even at undergraduate level, if you're having the research capability, that is the indirect thing that you're born researcher, you're having the capability to solve some unknown problems, some new situation, and everything you can do. And that carries some weight. That's why research is very, very important. IIIT Hyderabad, mostly undergraduate students used to publish their papers in conferences like CVPR, which is having H5 median, even more than that, the Journal of Nature. Okay. This is the topmost conference. Okay. This is the topmost venue to publish any recent or state of the art result. Okay. And you browse through IIIT Hyderabad, you will get a lot of students, UG students, those people are publishing all those things. So what happens? Those people are targeting the Google, those people are targeting the Microsoft, those people are targeting the Flipkart, the Amazon. But all major areas where those people can work. It means those people normally don't go only coding or debugging or website designing kind of thing, handling. Those people use only for research and development things. Those people used to go in data science, try to extract some sort of knowledge. And those people are mostly the strategist. How to develop the strategies, how to apply those strategies, that is important. Execution is one part, but the strategist is most important person or entity of any group. Until you have the best strategy, you cannot implement whatever team you're going to have, you're having. That will be actually useless. So ultimately, you have to become the strategist. And a strategist cannot become without having the research appetite. So believe, research is very, very important, even at your level. If I challenge you, even only 20 out of 100 students are now involved in research, they are publishing, maybe at very beginning, maybe very shallow papers, but ultimately, eventually, the depth will be attained, and then everybody will recognize you, not as BBDIT students, as good researcher. And jobs will come before you. You are not required to move, search the jobs. And exactly it is happening. There is a global crisis for the jobs, but global crisis for the jobs. For whom? Not for the strategist, not for the decision makers, for the ordinary students, okay, who can only implement, who only attained some sort of skill or knowledge, but not the analytical capabilities. So ultimately, you have to develop analytical capability. You should have the capabilities to understand something just by going through the literature. If any one of you can question yourself that you can understand one IEEE transaction paper very well and you can implement, I assume that you are a good researcher. Okay, and if you could do this thing, then I again want to assure you, you will not sit idle and you will develop something better than that. So first you have to understand, require the analytical capability, then implement that thing, try to attain some research appetite, and then do something better. So that's why research is nowadays target. Data is analytics or strategist positions. So believe on this thing and try to develop the research as
all right. Thank you so much, sir, for answering the question. Now, our next question is to Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan, sir. How good are college curriculums in making a young learner completely adept for the professional world? What else should college-going students do and learn to be more prepared for the professional life?
Of course, thank you for this question, but as you know, that question has two parts. First is how good the curriculum is, of course, vis-a-vis the needs of the profession. And secondly, is that what students should do so that they really do not feel that they have any deficiency or they have some shortcomings. So far as the first part is concerned, I would say it needs to be understood that the students' career choices are diverse. To fit every bill, it is quite challenging. It's quite difficult. That is why you see that all across the world, the different universities have different syllabus. Nonetheless, there is some common part, major common part. So this responsibility basically lies with the board of studies, even if it's an autonomous system or it is a university affiliating university system, because this affiliating university system is only in South Asia and this is also in a stage of disbanding. But since board of studies is there, and there comes the responsibility of teachers to really give the right kind of feedbacks, particularly in writing. So I would say And syllabus keeps changing. It is not that the syllabus do not keep changing. But to understand that, are they exactly in tune with time? Are they actually in fitting the bills, there is a need of industry representation. And I have seen that industry persons, even if they are invited to Board of Studies, they have restrictions of time and their involvement is limited. And this is an issue not only in, you know, a particular university, affiliating university, but even in NIITs or IIT. I think Professor Satish Kumar Singh, sir, will also vouch for me. So I would say Board of Studies keep trying syllabus. So nonetheless, there is always a scope of improvement, but I will not simply criticize it that it is not really up to the mark. No, because it, since it needs to cater to the needs of diverse professional needs. So so that is why they keep a bare minimum label so that it fits every bill. So it is not merely for research purposes that they design a syllabus. It is not merely for some software industry that they design their courses, whether for electrical or IT or CS. They're, the Board of Studies, since I have been a part of Board of Studies and academic also, a particular university or two universities at different times, they try to keep a balance and bare minimum kind of thing so that no student feels that he didn't have anything to feed his or her need. So, but nonetheless, I think there is always a scope of improvement. The frequency could always be improved because usually the syllabus changes are once in a year and that too in a very limited stage, a limited percentage. So yes, I think there is always a call, there is always a pressure in terms of updating it and particularly having a representation from industry and engaging them meaningfully. Now coming to the second question, that what students should do. I think here AICT's new directives, which was issued almost a year back, and it was a paper of 60 odd pages, in which they have emphasized the need of internship. And they said that if you are doing a 4-year course, you should do a training for almost 6 months. And since earlier, it was only done up post third year, now it has to be done every year. So a student must understand that this is not something that is being done compulsively. It is exactly to fulfill that gap between academic syllabus and the industry needs. So I think you must take this as a golden opportunity that once your first year is over, you go for that internship for 4 to 6 weeks, and you should really impatiently plan for that. Okay, that which industry you will be doing, what project you are going to do. And even in winter, there is so-called, it used to be called winter break earlier, but it is no more valid now. You get a break of 2 weeks or so. You should again look for something that you can do meaningfully. And what you got, it take away in last year's summer internship, and do that work in winter internship. And if you can associate yourself with the industry for these 15 days also, which is very difficult, then if you get this opportunity, I think you should again associate yourself with that same industry, or maybe choice of your skill, or maybe stream of technology. And you may be glad to know, those who are really inclined to do well once they are in final year and get placed in the industry, and particularly in terms of knowledge creation, what Professor Satish Kumar Singh was hinting about, then you must understand that in new national education policy has now made it that after, you know, primary section means 6 months, you should go for such kind of trainings in every summer breaks. So it's not no more valid only for engineering, that 6th onwards you are supposed to do these kind of internship so that you can make yourself well prepared in area of your choice, and you can also judge upon whether you are really patient, you are passionate about certain things. Okay, so since now you are an engineering student, my recommendation to you is that to bridge this gap, AICT has given these directives, and IITs have also on their own taken this up, that, you know, in summer internships or winter internship, you should go to the industry, you should work for industry, whether you are physically there or not physically there, but working under the supervision of those persons who are doing working in the industry and doing really well. and they could be your mentor, or you really look up to them in terms of their knowledge, in terms of their efficiency, in terms of the organization in which they are working upon. So formally or informally, and preferably formally, you should work with those kind of projects. So I think that is the right way. And if you have a research bent of mind, of course, working on some research areas or research lab, associating yourself with the research lab, and particularly in this online times, where there are so many opportunities, you need to just really go on those searching and then targeting them and then putting your proposals. Don't look for that somebody will target you. Rather, you prepare yourself a reasonable work, a reasonable proposal, and then hit the right person. Believe me, even a stranger, if he or she puts right proposal to a person who may be in a different land or different country, and if you make an impact, they are really keen to that. In fact, some of your seniors are there in electrical department, and they have been in the international conference. There was a professor who was a director and very eminent professors who had so many huge publications. He was from Slovak country, and he said that they are desperate for researchers. So some of your students might have noted down the detail. I do also have. So they were saying that they always look for good students who can work on certain projects, or who can propose certain, who can come out with certain proposals. So I think associating with the right kind of persons, looking for these summer periods and winter periods, any period which is dull, as a golden opportunity, and understanding this ICT systems, and particularly the power of internet and online, you know, resources and linkage. I think if you really work on them with a focus minded, because online it's like a digital sea, you may sway if you are not really focused. So work on them, and all above these things, I would say associate with these kind of platforms such as IEEE, because they help you to be in network with so many persons with so many different skills. And I think you will find a right match if you keep looking in this digital world with a right focus. So that is what I will say. I think I have answered the first part as well, in terms of, so I do not see much of the weakness on syllabus part, because I see that how hard work the academic council or board of studies do. But nonetheless, if any teachers or you as a student find that certain things should be there, you can put to your teachers, and teachers are always welcome to write to the dean, undergraduate studies. They do incorporate these kind of suggestions whenever the board of studies meetings take up. And beside that, elective choices are also one thing that gives you this kind of choice, that if you have an stream, you can propose to your department for a particular electives, and if reasonable number of students are there, those electives are also taken up. So that way, I think syllabus do take care to certain extent, and considering the fact that it has to cater to the students, all sorts of students, some of them may be having an ambitions for MBA, some of them may be having an ambition for MS, some of them might be thinking of IES or IAS or UPSC or public services examination. So they are of diverse interests, and syllabus are constrained, designed such a way that they give the skill to all of them. They also cater to the persons who might be thinking of once in a while undergrad research. So considering those constraints, the syllabus are designed to an optimum level. So nonetheless, it still leaves a scope. That is why they are on their heels always, working hard. But regarding the students part, what should they do? I think they should look for these internships as a golden period. They should not at all believe in so-called these kind of misnomer or wrong words, like winter vacation or summer vacations. There's no term, no more valid. These terms are no more valid for engineering education. You have only summer internships and winter internship. You are living in an age of competition, and it's not a competition in a negative sense. It's a healthy, competing with the self, and you cannot afford to waste your time. And I think these periods should be utilized to pursue your interest, to do something which really you reflect in the biodata. When you pose your candidature for any position, whether it is a research position or MS or interview for a public service commission or anywhere. So, and I have seen so many students in AKTU or in other institutes who even at the end of second year, they have a huge biodata. And in just one summer break, they do extraordinary thing. Not in recent time, even in earlier times. So you must realize that you cannot afford to waste the time. So I think my recommendations are clear. And I hope I have answered the query. And thank you for this question. To the webmaster, Shivali Prasad. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. That was surely very, very enlightening. And it was very eye-opening for a lot of us. I want to tell the speakers that you can look at the questions on the chat section as well in case I am not audible. And to the viewers who are asking, can you ask questions? Yes, you can definitely ask questions. We'll put up your questions to the speakers. For instance, somebody just asked, what are the best ways to think of ideas for a startup? Dr. Satish, I would like to ask this question to you. What are the best ways to think of ideas for a startup?
What are best ways to think of ideas? Okay.
Yes, so, sir, for a startup.
Yes, that is slightly tough question. What are the best ways to think? Okay. To think, it's fine, but best ways to think for a startup idea. Okay. So, for example, if I give a problem, okay, what is the problem? Since I do research in the domain of image processing, computer vision kind of issues, okay? And I have a problem that I have to identify the persons on road in the night condition, okay? I want to develop an automation system, driver assistance system, where even if in night scenario, if some living object is on road at very far distance, that should be detected by the car and a warning may be issued to the driver. Okay, so that just to avoid the chances of collision, okay, or some sort of hazardous accidents. Okay, so this is the objective. Now, what are the problems? I tell you, what is the basic problem? Suppose we are trying to develop a machine learning based system. What is the most challenging thing? To develop some system, to develop some algorithm is fine. Okay, if you have sufficient exposure, okay, it's fine. You can develop, but where is the main problem? Main problem is the annotation of those scenes. For example, you have to collect lakhs and crores of such images and during the night situation, varying illumination, maybe very dim light to dark night to tree light, etc. Variety of situations are there and variety of places are there, okay? Variety of situations are there, variety of objects are there, and you have to train the model. In that case, annotations are required. Okay, annotations are required means you have to see the scene and then you have to annotate, okay, this is the person, this is the car, this is something else. Okay, so these kind of annotations are required. If you have the annotated data, then only your models can be trained. Okay. Then only your models can be trained. So earlier in India, there was no such industry. Okay, here lot of skills are not required. Okay, it means it doesn't require huge knowledge of anything, or you can say many things. Only some limited set of skills are sufficient to do this task. But what is problem? Problem is simple, that you need to sit before the system for a long time. You have to watch through each and every image or scene, and then manually you have to annotate that data. Can you believe that data annotation is done completely or manually even today? Because you're going to develop some expert system on the basis of some data which is human interpretable. Getting the things. So can you believe IIIT Hyderabad students developed few startups which are working very well. Those people are working for Microsoft. Those people are working for Google. Those people are working for NVIDIA just for data annotation. And huge money is being fished from those companies because those people are getting the money in dollars. Okay? So this was simple idea. Now you can see there are many, about 10 to 12 companies which are doing only data annotation. Data annotation. Got it? So basically, startups are originated on the basis of certain problems. If you have problem, then only you have to solve it. Okay? At mass scale, requirement should be at mass scale. If you are starting a company where requirement is very limited, you are going to manufacture something which is required by only some group, maybe only some research organization. So only few products will be sold. Okay, your idea may be very good, but that idea should not be implemented in the form of a startup rather than doing some sort of research or joining some research group. Okay, so this way, first you should identify the needs of the society, needs of the community, needs of the self, and then for solving those needs or fulfilling those needs, you should ideate with and you should try to develop some sort of startups. Okay. For example, you have wonderful computation facility. I give you one idea. If you have developed the wonderful computational facility, okay, so you can develop this computational facility via some startup. Your startup can start this activity at your institution. And how this startup will make the money? You can outsource your computational facility to nearby needy people. Who are those needy people? For example, those needy people like me, like some students, if we are doing some sort of research and huge computational facilities are required, I can outsource those computational facility via net. Okay, that facility can be used. Okay, so Amazon and other cloud services, cloud service providers are providing those facilities at mass scales, but you can start those things at very humble states. Okay, maybe for some other institutions as well, you develop computational facility, make some arrangements with other institutions, collaborate with them, charge them maybe very small amount and outsource your facilities. So normally what happens, the entire computational facility is shut down during the night time, use it, and that facility can be used by some people from the country where there is this situation and their working hours are still going on. Okay, so these are small ideas. And you can implement those ideas, okay? So, I mean, for starting a startup, it is not required to have very big ideas. Try to solve some problems. Means try to solve simple problems. Simple problems are very frequent, very common. Means large number of people will be affected by those simple problems. But complicated problems are handled by sophisticated people are sophisticated entity or very rare entity where your idea may not get the full reward. Okay, so this strategy must be adopted. Okay, and believe that in IEEE, if you have such idea, you write the proposal. For example, IEEE is facing a problem. Okay, what is the problem? Do you have, means India is not having any EDAS kind of review system or any easy chair kind of review system. Getting the point, we have to organize the conference. We are completely dependent upon those foreign people. Maybe easy chair of CMT. Can we develop such system? I mean, huge skills are required to develop such systems. Only some knowledge of the database and web development is sufficient to develop such systems. But still, we could not develop such systems. If you develop such systems, then definitely these will be a good revenue model. These will be a good revenue model. Got it? So this way, anything can be start, but ultimately there should be a will to work. Until you have the will, even having good ideas, most of the ideas will be wasted. That's all. So IEEE requires many softwares, many small plugins, and there are many opportunities where your ideas are directly being used by IEEE. Okay, so normally IEEE submission system, IEEE dissemination system, everything is developed by IEEE slowly, slowly. Okay, so you can target those things. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. You would definitely write that startups should try to solve simple problems, and somebody.
Shrikant Shivali's mic is off.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay, so I want to thank Dr. Satish for the answer. You were definitely right that the startups should focus on the needs of society and try to solve simple problems. Somebody just asked that what should startups focus on? I think that answers your question. And as sir said, as long as you have the will to work, it should all work out. Our next question is to Dr. Chauhan. Somebody asks that as an undergraduate student planning to go for higher studies, how do I begin to develop my research skills being a complete beginner?
Thank you, Shirley. You know, this was partly, I would say, almost completely answered by Professor Satish Kumar Singh sir in his initial answers, or while he was addressing in general, in his initial address, that you know you should see good research paper, and then of course see that whether you are able to understand them, and then approach some professor means within the institute itself, and keep working on those products, particularly by implementing. And if you are able to implement, then it is a validation that yes, you can go for the research. So, balki main Javed Akhtar saab ka ek seminar tha. Javed Akhtar ke naam se aap lagbhag shayad aadhe se zyada student parichit honge. To wo kehte the aksar apne seminar mein, ek live seminar mein unko kehte hue suna ki agar aap 10,000 share ya 1,000 share agar unko main sankhya ko kam kar dun, तो अगर पढ़ लेते हैं तो ये लाजमी शेयर देंगे, तो पता लगे कि आप अपने मुशायरे में पढ़े ना पढ़े। तो इसी तरीके से रिसर्च पेपर के बारे में भी ये सही है कि अगर आप रिसर्च पेपर्स पढ़ते रहते हैं और आपको ये फैसिनेट करते हैं आपके एरिया ऑफ इंटरेस्ट में, तो ये ऑब्वियस है कि आपको भी कुछ उसमें कुछ परमिटेशन कम्बिनेशन दिखाई देने लगेंगे, एंड यू विल फील एन अर्ज टू वर्क इम्प्लीमेंट देम एंड देन मेक योर ओन चेंजेस. सो दैट इज अ राइट वे ऑफ डूइंग. बिसाइड दैट अभी जो प्रोफेसर सतीश कुमार सर स्टार्टअप्स के बारे में जिक्र कर रहे थे, तो विद हिज परमिशन ही रियली आंसर्ड वेरी वेल. मैं एक दो पॉइंट इसमें ऐड जरूर करना चाहूँगा कि जो लोग स्टार्टअप को लेके पैशनेट हैं, आई रियली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सल्यूट देम एज ए टीचर, बिकॉज दैट इज अ नीड ऑफ नेशन, नीड ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. इसमें खासतौर पर बहुत ज्यादा अगर किसी बीमारी को लेकर तो आप डॉक्टर के पास जाते हैं, तो फिजिकली ज़रूरी नहीं है तो फिर आप टेली कॉन्टैक्ट करते हैं, अपने डॉक्टर से फ़ोन से बात करते हैं. इसी तरीके से इस केस में एक इंडिया ने बहुत ही अच्छा स्टेप लिया था 80s में, और वो अब उसके रिजल्ट्स भी दिखाई देने लगे हैं. इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंडिया ये एक वेबसाइट है, ज़रूरी नहीं कि आप वहाँ जाके कोर्स करें या वहाँ आप 2 साल का कोर्स करें. लोग फॉरेन यूनिवर्सिटी में भी जो बिजनेसमैन फैमिली से होते हैं उनको अपना फैमिली बिजनेस आगे बढ़ाना है तो भी इस तरीके के 2-2 साल के MBA करते हैं. IIMs में भी ये MBA की फैसिलिटी है, लेकिन आपके लिए अगर ये मुमकिन नहीं है, क्योंकि कभी कभी एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप बहुत जल्दी टेक ऑफ लेना जाता है, देयर इज नो आइडियल वे. बहुत से लोग बहुत यंग एज में एंटरप्रेन्योर बन जाते हैं और सक्सेसफुल भी हैं, तो इस केस में मैं ये जरूर कहूंगा कि आप ईडीआई की वेबसाइट के टच में रहें, वो बहुत सारी रिसोर्सेज और मटेरियल इस रेफरेंस में देते हैं जो बहुत मीनिंगफुल हैं। मैंने एंटरप्रेन्योर से डिस्कस करके भी ये पाया है, ये ऐसा नहीं कि केवल टीचर ऐसा कहते हैं, क्योंकि वो गवर्नमेंट की क्या पॉलिसीज हैं, कहाँ से आपको मदद मिल सकती है, क्या तरीके हैं, क्यों अगर आप किसी किसी प्रोडक्ट पे काम कराना जरूरी है, चाहे वो कॉमन प्रॉब्लम पे रिलेटेड हो, चाहे वो स्पेसिफिक प्रॉब्लम पर रिलेटेड हो, अदरवाइज यू फील चीटेड। क्योंकि ट्रेडिंग करना, किसी चीज को खरीद लेना, उसको एक मार्जिन पे बेच देना, ये एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप नहीं है। एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप वो है जो प्रोफेसर सतीश कुमार सिंह सर ने अभी कहा कि आप प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग को अप्रोच करें, और वो प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है बहुत सिंपल प्रॉब्लम हो, या हो सकता है एक टेक्नोलॉजिकल प्रॉब्लम हो, वो डिपेंड करता है आपके इंटरेस्ट पे। और इसके लिए इंजीनियर होना जरूरी नहीं है, आप इंजीनियर होके भी बहुत सिंपल प्रॉब्लम ले सकते हैं, और एक सिंपल आदमी भी एक इंजीनियर है। बिजनेस विच इज रियली इंपॉर्टेंट, और उसकी डिफरेंट डायमेंशन है, पूरे साइकिल्स हैं उसमें, ऐसे भी साइकिल आते हैं जहाँ की कभी आप राइज भी करते हैं। तो मैं कहूंगा EDII इस वर्ड को नोट कर लें, जो रियली स्टार्टअप को लेकर सीरियस है। एंड देन स्टार्टअप क्लब्स भी अब कॉलेजेस में फॉर्म हो रहे हैं, तो मैं यहाँ कॉल ऑन करूंगा इलेक्ट्रिकल के डिपार्टमेंट के HOD को, डॉक्टर खादिम मोइन सिद्दीकी को, और बाकी फैकल्टीज को, कि वो लोग भी अपने डिपार्टमेंट में एक स्टार्टअप क्लब बनाए, 3-4 लोग सिमिलर माइंड्स के, और उनको हम फैसिलिटेट कर सकते हैं। यकीनन ये यहाँ मैं कॉल ऑफ कर रहा हूँ, एंड आई कंसीडर इट माई ड्यूटी ऑल्सो।
यस सर, वी शैल डू आवर बेस्ट, थैंक यू सो मच सर।
तो ये बहुत अच्छी बात है, क्योंकि अगर सारे लोग जॉब ही ढूंढते रहेंगे तो जॉब नहीं आएंगे, ये एक फैक्ट है, इससे बैलेंस काइंड ऑफ थिंग। और ऐसा नहीं, AKTU के काफी स्टूडेंट्स पास्ट में मैंने देखा है, बहुत अच्छे सक्सेसफुल एंटरप्रेन्योर हुए हैं डिफरेंट इंस्टीट्यूट से। सो आई रियली सैल्यूट दोज हु आर थिंकिंग ऑन दोज लाइंस, एंड मार्क दिस वर्ड EDII। ये बहुत एक्सेसिबल हैं, बहुत हेल्प करते हैं, और केवल फीस के बेस पे नहीं करते हैं, दे आर डूइंग रियली एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी वर्क, दे आर रियली हेल्पिंग टू हेल्प एनीबॉडी हु इज रियली थिंकिंग एज एन एंटरप्रेन्योर लाइंस। तो ये मेरा बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग रिकमेंडेशन है। तो मैंने शायद जो क्वेश्चन मेरे सामने पोस्ट किया था हमारी वेब मास्टर शिवाली प्रसाद ने, उसको भी प्रोफेसर सतीश कुमार सिंह को ही कोट किया है, उन्होंने इस चीज का पहले से ही जवाब दे दिया था, और दूसरा इस EDII को। और एक साथ एक बात और मैं कहना चाहूंगा स्टार्टअप के बारे में, कि एक बहुत आम कहावत है जो आप सभी ने सुनी है कि बिग थिंग्स कम्स विद बिग रिस्क। तो जब भी आप कुछ बड़ा सोचते हैं तो यकीनन रिस्क फैक्टर बढ़ जाता है, और अदरवाइज बहुत रूटीन सोच रहे हैं आप जो दुनिया करती आई है, और देन यू विल बी अननोन आफ्टर मे बी वंस यू आर नो मोर इन द वर्ल्ड आफ्टर 20 years, नो और मे बी 40 years, एक्सेप्ट योर किथ एंड किन, दोज हु हैव अ प्रॉपर्टी इशू। ये बिटर ट्रूथ है लाइफ के, अगर बड़ा सोच रहे हैं तो ये रिस्क भी है, और रिस्क लेना कभी भी गलत नहीं है, प्रोवाइडेड वो रिस्क कैलकुलेटेड हो। एंड व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय कैलकुलेटेड रिस्क, मींस जब आपने प्रॉपर तैयारी के साथ आप आगे बढ़े, और या आप अपने आप को तैयार करते रहे समय समय पे, किस पे, डिफरेंट थ्योरीज पे, या उनके पास्ट एक्सपीरियंसेस पे जो लोगों ने काम किया है। तो ये मेरी रिकमेंडेशंस हैं, आई रियली सैल्यूट दोज हु आर थिंकिंग ऑन दोज लाइंस, मे गॉड ब्लेस यू, एंड आई थिंक इंडिया एज ए कंट्री वैल्यू इट हाईली, एंड दैट इज द नीड ऑफ द नेशन। तो थैंक यू फॉर दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी। एट द सेम टाइम मैं ऑर्गेनाइजर्स से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि मुझको उन्हें परमिट करना होगा, कल से एग्जाम है, और एक मीटिंग ऑलरेडी राइट नाउ शेड्यूल्ड है, मैंने उसको थोड़ा पोस्टपोन किया था। एंड मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि मेरे लिए और मैं परमिशन मांगूंगा प्रोफेसर सतीश कुमार सिंह सर से भी कि मुझे परमिट करें कि मैं थोड़ा पहले थोड़ा परमिशन ले रहा हूँ सर, और एक सेशन बाद में भी मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि मुझको ये अपॉर्चुनिटी दी जाए। आई एम रियली लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड फॉर सच काइंड ऑफ सेशन, आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू पर्सन फॉर हिज एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी मेंटरशिप एंड गाइडेंस दैट ही हैज गिविंग, एंड द वे ही हैज पैट्रोनाइज्ड अस इन पास्ट आल्सो। सर, नाउ वी हैव अ डीप कनेक्ट विद यू, एंड वी फील सो ऑब्लाइज्ड, एंड आई ऑफर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एज वेल एज ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल द फैकल्टी एंड ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर प्रेजेंट ऑन दिस फोरम और were there in the previous event, a deep sense of gratitude towards you. Thank you, Dr. Khadim and Professor Rafi, kindly permit me because I have to move into.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. We have discussed all the questions assigned to you, and now we have some questions for Satish sir. Then we can finish the function after that.
So nice of you. And thank Professor Satish Kumar,
thank you so much, sir.
Kindly permit.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes, Shivali, you can continue, please.
Okay, so audience, that was our director, Dr. Bhash Kumar Chauhan, sir. Now moving on, my next question is to Dr. Singh. Somebody has asked that how to find someone to mentor me for my research idea and how to collaborate with other people and form groups for big projects.
Well, so if you talk about the research idea, okay. So it means you have already identified the research domain, okay? And this is the era of internet, okay? So you can find out many people near you, okay? You can find out many people near you who can help you, okay? And it's very easy. If you have such queries, you can raise these queries to your student branch counselor, and your student branch counselor can contact at section level as well. If somebody is interested in guiding those people or collaborating those people, it's quite easy. Okay, it's quite easy. If you have some will, you want to collaborate or you want to get some sort of collaboration. Remember first thing, collaboration is at equal level. Okay, you can get the guidance, but you cannot collaborate until you yourself is offering some sort of benefit. It means it is win-win situation for both the people who are collaborating. Okay, so don't think about the collaboration. First, think of getting some sort of supervision or some sort of guidance from such people. Develop your research skills, show certain outputs, showcase your research capabilities, and then only people will be willing to collaborate you because you can provide something in turn. Okay, until you can provide, nobody is willing to collaborate. So first you try to explore, you try to get some good people, good research groups where you can work. Okay, you can look for various IITs, various NITs, various IITs, various state universities. There are so many good people at, in fact, all institutions, in your institutions as well. You can get many good faculty members who are very well inclined and in line with your research ideas. Okay. First, you put up your ideas and get a kind of validation or kind of what you can say endorsement first. Sometimes what happens at UG level, UG students are quite hypothetical in nature, okay? They always will to build the ships or planes kind of things, okay? They don't consider very small problems, okay? Very deeper problems. Deeper problems are very crisp or very small problems. UG students try to think about the systems, but within that system, there are even thousands of the problems. Those problems must be considered and should be made crisp. Then only you can target those people. You can discuss with those people. Okay. So try to identify the problem, the research domain. Try to identify some people nearby, the nearest first, and then increase the radius of your circle, and then try to find out those people. IEEE can help definitely. You can pose those kind of queries to your student branch counselor. He can pass on to section, and section can pass on to all the members of IEEE, around 2,000 members in UP, and large number of members from India itself. At Asia level also, RTEN level also, if your query is valid and you're quite enthusiastic and promising, definitely you will get a good group and good response from that group. Rest assured. Srikant.
Okay.
Chivali.
Okay, sir. So before opening up the session to the audience, there is one last question that we have for you. What are the things you wish you knew before starting your career as a person in STEM?
Regarding me?
Yes, sir. Like, if, when you started off in as a person in engineering, so what were the things that you wish you knew at that point, so that our the young learners present in the audience can also know about it?
So, you believe or not, I strongly believed in the fact that I can do this thing. Okay, whatever I thought, it was in my back of the mind that I can do this thing. I was knowing only this thing. Okay, and until you take the step, you don't think, you cannot find so many paths where to move, but slowly take step by step and move forward. Obviously, my taste was technical. Okay, at that time when I passed in 2003, I did my BTech. At that time, most of the people were going for either for software, there was a downside at that time, or some sort of call centers as well. Okay, people were joining that job. But before that, I decided to go in technical field only. I decided to stick with the technical field. Okay, in second year, after second year, I appeared for the GATE and I qualified at that time itself. Okay, it was very well decided in my mind that I have to opt for the technical field only. I have to go for the higher studies only. Okay, so this was well decided. And I tell you one thing, and this is my experience only. You may agree, you may not agree with the fact. Fact, as per my opinion. If you have choices, you cannot succeed. Remember, if you have choices, you cannot succeed. Adding to few points to your startup ideas, I tell you, I inform you one thing. Here at IIIT Allahabad, we are having this innovation and incubation center. Okay, we are having this design and innovation center, DIC, we are having IIC, we are having NewGen IDC, etc. We are having three wonderful centers. And many startups have been incubated. Incubation took place. Government of India granted some money in the tune of 25 lakh rupees to those startups. Okay, around 11 startups have been incubated in IIIT Allahabad. Okay, but what I say, I am not very much happy with the performance of those startups. What is the reason? The reason is simple. They are having a variety of choices. If you're looking for the startup, you should look only for the startup, not for the jobs and other things. You should drop your idea to do any job for next 10 years at least. For next 10 years at least. Because any startup cannot be set up in 1, 2, or 3 years. Remember this thing. At least 10 years time is required to set up the startup, set up your idea. Okay, so you leave everything that you will sit in the campus, you will go for the job and other things. Each and every second of your life should be spent just for thinking the startup, just for thinking the growth of the startup. Then only your startup will be succeeded. So that is the reason why only few, very meager percent of the startups are succeeding, and most of the startups are being shut down after 3-4 years. This is the biggest reason, because those people are having the choices. कि मैं आपको एक clear cut बताता हूँ. मैं आपसे अगर एक सवाल करूँ कि आप क्या करने वाले हैं? आप higher studies में जाएंगे कि आप job में जाएंगे? पता है? 90% और 99% स्टूडेंट्स का जवाब ये होता है कि हमारे स्टडीज में तो जाना चाहते हैं, लेकिन पहले हम 2 साल जॉब कर लेंगे. दिस इज द थिंग. सेकंड, आप रिसर्च करना चाहते हैं या अच्छी जॉब के लिए जाना चाहते हैं? हम रिसर्च करना चाहते हैं, टू बी वेरी आइडियल, हम रिसर्च करना चाहते हैं, लेकिन हम पहले प्लेसमेंट में बैठ करके नौकरी भी सिक्योर करना चाहते हैं. तो इस तरीके के जब तक डुअल माइंड्स होंगे, यानी दोहरी थिंकिंग होगी, तब तक आप किसी भी एक डोमेन में सक्सेस नहीं पा सकते हैं. ये आप याद रख लीजिए और लिख करके अपने जेब्स में रख लीजिए, जेबों में, ठीक है। जब तक आपके पास चॉइस है तब तक आप एक्सेल कर नहीं सकते। जिस दिन आपके पास केवल एक ही चॉइस होगी उस दिन आप सक्सेस आपको मिल जाएगी, दैट इज फॉर श्योर। ओके, सो डोंट कीप चॉइसेस इन योर लाइफ। इफ यू आर हैविंग अ चॉइसेस यू कैन नॉट एक्सेल, दैट्स इट।
Okay, thank you, sir. So it's basically to have a laser sharp focus and to basically respect your goal and not have second options.
Yes.
All right. So now the platform is open for the audience to ask questions. You can unmute yourself and ask a question, but please don't be disrespectful in any way or you will be removed from the meeting. Anyone who wants to ask can unmute themselves.
Shivali, if any participant does not have question right now, then we can ask to Shati sir for yes sir, sir for yes
Shri Gautam Bhasiya.
Yes, you are audible. Then you can ask a question. Then Shivali, you can take the email ID of Shatish sir and circulate and send to participants. So after that, they can ask the question if they have, if they generate. Okay. Yes, Shri Gautam Bhatia. Now you can ask a question.
Hello, sir. It was a very informative session and I really liked it. So my question was this. So how do we decide that we should pursue some short-term goals or go for the long-term goals? Because for previous 6 months to at least 8 months, I've been focusing on one particular domain and when very small particular domain. But if I see for now, I haven't got any particular results to showcase. So research is going very hard for me, but I cannot get any collaborations because I don't have any solid results. So how can I decide, should I go on or maybe leave, because I don't have any person to look up to. So should I keep on doing research or not? But I have many friends and seniors who have bagged placements. So one side we have many mentors and people who we can look up to for placements, but on the other research side there is very meagre support. We don't have anything to go on, or I'm still finding reasons. So how to continue?
So the major problem is not with the thing that whether you should continue or discontinue. Major problem is you're not getting the feedback whatever you're getting.
Yes, okay? Sir.
Means whether you're doing in the right direction or not. This is the major problem. Okay. So ultimately, for example, I'm doing something. So I can consider myself a person doing something which may be very, very novel for us. Okay. So, but certainly, I'm not sure whether this will be recognized by the peer group or not. What is peer group? The peer group is the group of persons who are working in the same domain or even on same problem. Okay, so until you get the feedback from those persons, your idea cannot be validated, your efforts cannot be recognized, or you will not get sufficient motivation to do the research. Okay, and this happens just because you're having the scarcity of such people. In that case, if you have some idea, you have done something, try to connect with the appropriate person and try to get a chance to discuss whether your thinking is in the right direction or not. Okay, even if your thinking is not right, but if you have done something, then the next person can think, okay, this person is having some sort of research appetite, research potential, analytical capabilities, then he can tweak your idea, okay, and can give the feedback, why don't you try this rather than trying this. Okay, so these kind of feedbacks are very, very important at very early stage. Okay, so I started my research in the domain of image processing. why I started the research in the domain of image processing, because I did my master's in the lasers and applications. This is a hardcore engineering topic. Okay, lasers and application. I did my master's project thesis work, 1 year thesis was complete in power electronic systems. But when I joined the teaching, I could not get such laboratory. Okay, so what I thought, how I can continue research while using minimum resources. Then I explored the domain. I interacted with so many people. Few of my friends were in the industry at that time itself, ST Microelectronics and other. So there I visited few research laboratory Ahmedabad, research laboratory in Dehradun. We interacted with the scientists. Then I could get the interest. Okay, here I can work with the minimum resources, means only computers which have been provided by our organizations will be sufficient to do some sort of research. And those research can be important. It is, you have to put the most appropriate places, venues, okay, and persons to connect. And you believe or not, people are ready, very much ready to help you if you are enthusiastic enough. Okay, aap aisa nahi soch ke aa rahe hum to ye ki hame to kuch mil nahi, only excuses not work. Aap ek is habit ko chhod dijiye, kisi bhi situation ke liye aap zimmedar hain, theek hai, koi dusra zimmedar nahi hai, na to samay zimmedar hai, na to koi paristhiti hai, na hi koi person hai, na aap parents hain. किसी भी सिचुएशन के लिए सिर्फ और सिर्फ आप जिम्मेदार हैं. तो ट्राई टू लीव टू गिव सम एक्सक्यूज, लीव द एक्सक्यूजेस, डेफिनेटली यू विल गेट द पाथ, यू विल गेट द ऐसे ग्रुप से कनेक्ट करना पड़ेगा, ऐसे पर्सन से कनेक्ट करना पड़ेगा जिसने उस डोमेन में काफी वर्क किया हो. ठीक है, देन ओनली यू कैन गेट द राइट फीडबैक. सो दैट्स इट. एंड IEEE कैन वेरी वेल हेल्प फॉर दिस पर्पस. ओके, इफ यू हैव सम आइडिया, यू हैव डन समथिंग, यू फ्लोट द आइडिया, पीपल आर रेडी टू गिव द फीडबैक. ओके, so this is the thing. Hello, even adding to one more thing, you can get the feedback, you submit your idea, you submit your work in some good conference. Okay, your work will be reviewed by at least 3 experts and then you will get the feedback. Sometimes feedbacks are too bad, we think that these are too bad, but these feedbacks are too good for us to grow. Remember, no feedback is bad. Paper review feedbacks are always good. Don't think those feedbacks as bad feedbacks, because you get the right direction to work. If you start working in that direction, you start answering those questions, even your paper is rejected, still improve your paper. Don't leave at that place itself. Okay, you try to answer, you try to incorporate all those suggestions, ultimately your work will be improved enough. Okay, aap usko beech mein chhod denge to iska matlab aap willing kabhi the hi nahi. Aapka kya tha interest? To get some paper in a conference, that's all. Your opinion, I mean will, was not to do some good research. Okay, so getting rejection is always motivating, not demotivating.
सर मेरा थोड़ा सा क्वेश्चन ना कम्युनिकेट नहीं हो पाया. कैन आई रीफ्रेम द क्वेश्चन अ लिटिल बिट?
यस यस
अलाउड. सर एक्चुअली सर मैंने 6 या 8 महीने ना सर टीम के साथ काम कर रहा था सर, और वो स्पेशल रिकग्निशन
की आपने किसी प्रॉब्लम पे काम किया? यस
सर.
And now you're confused whether you should continue or you should leave this.
Sir, क्योंकि problem ये है sir के financial conditions और बहुत सारे factors को continue करके अब मेरे को ये समझ नहीं आ रहा कि इतना एफर्ट में, मतलब बहुत ज्यादा एफर्ट में हमें बेटर रिजल्ट दूसरे डोमेन में मिल सकते हैं, तो हमें इस डोमेन में ही जाना चाहिए या नहीं, वो थोड़ा कंफ्यूजिंग हो जाता है।
देखिए, ये आपके इंटरेस्ट पे डिपेंड करता है, ठीक है। रिसर्च इज ऑलवेज रिवॉर्डिंग इफ इट इज डन इन द राइट डायरेक्शन। गेटिंग द पॉइंट? आप एग्री कर सकते हैं मेरे इस पॉइंट से? इफ यू हैव अ गुड पेटेंट, गुड पेटेंट मींस यूजलेस पेटेंट्स तो बहुत हो सकते हैं, गुड पेटेंट्स बहुत रेयर होंगे। इफ यू हैव गुड पेटेंट एंड रियली यूजफुल, ओके, देन आई मीन विद इन नाइट्स यू कैन बी द मिलियनर्स बिलियनर्स। गेटिंग द पॉइंट? तो रिसर्च इज ऑलवेज रिवॉर्डिंग, डोंट थिंक दैट बाय डूइंग रिसर्च, गुड रिसर्च, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू गुड गेटिंग समथिंग। You will get, but provided your research should be impactful. ठीक है, हम कुछ भी कोडिंग करते रहते हैं, we can say okay we are doing research, we are doing research, but in true sense whether this is research or not, whether people are going to recognize us or not, that is important. तो जब तक आप state of the art research नहीं करेंगे, तब तक वो useless ही होगा, and you may not get that reward which it should get, okay? So, आप confused हैं, confused in the sense कि whether you should go for higher studies, research or for jobs.
Yes, sir.
By doing less efforts, but by putting less efforts, when this becomes less efforts, वहीं पे purpose defeat हो जाता है.
Thank you so much, sir, for so your my, answer.
What? What?
Does anyone else have any questions?
So can we connect to you through LinkedIn or email if possible?
Yes, I have IDs, so you can connect with us.
So how can we find you on LinkedIn, sir?
Dr. Satish Kumar Singh, IIIT, Allahabad.
After this program, we will share details of sir in the WhatsApp group. So please wait, all participants.
Yes, anyone who wants to connect to Professor Singh, they can ask us and we'll share the contact details with you. If anybody else, if none of you have any questions, then I'll move forward. Now I invite our event organizer, Dr. Khadim Moin Siddiqui, for the vote of thanks.
Hello. Yes, actually, all participants, we are exceeding time. So if you have any question, we will share contact details in your WhatsApp group. Then you can ask to sir later on. So I'm going to give vote of thanks. A very good afternoon, honorable speaker, Dr. Satish Kumar Singh, Vice Chair, IEEE Uttar Pradesh Section. Honorable Director, BBDITM, Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan, respected HOD, E&EN, Professor Rafiq Ahmed, Dr. Parthish Paul, Branch Counselor, ADGITM Delhi, faculty participants, student participants, and volunteers. It's my proud privilege to propose vote of thanks on the third day of 7-day event, IEEE Virtual Bootcamp under IEEE Art and Sec Membership Development and Leadership Training on title Counseling Session on the Scope of STEM. Today, for counseling session, we can say have two eminent and ideal academicians, professionals, educators, researchers, counselors, and many more. Yes, we have Honorable Vice Chair, IEEE UP Section, Professor Satish Kumar Singh, and Honorable Director, BBDITM, Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan,
they had accepted our invitation gladly for today's counseling session in this event. Today, we have observed large number of students, faculties, and volunteers have joined to listen and learn from two most eminent speakers. Thank you so much, Professor Dr. Satish Kumar Singh, Honorable Vice Chair, IEEE UP section, for this counseling session. And you have given all the answers in the efficient way. Thank you so much, sir, for giving us your valuable time and also for motivating us to think towards research from undergraduate levels, emphasis for a startup, and also demonstrated how one can think and generate constructive ideas for the benefits of humanity. Honorable sir, thank you so much again. Thank you so much, Professor Dr. Bhavesh Kumar Chauhan, Honorable Director, BBDITM Lucknow, for your readiness to accept each and every invitation gladly and always like to give us novel ideas to organize programs for the benefits of students and faculty, and also always encourages us to produce students vibrant, skilled, self-motivated, and from their learned abilities, one must be ready to compete in national as well as international level. Honorable sir, again, thank you so much. Further, I would like to thank to our respected HOD, Professor Rafiq Ahmed, for his support. Sir, due to your support and efforts, we are unable to organize this program in the effective way. I extend my thanks to Dr. Parthish Paul, Branch Counselor, IEEE Student Branch, Akhilesh Das Gupta, Institute of Technology and Management, Delhi, for their support. Now, thanks to all faculty participants, student participants for joining us and making the event successful. At last, thanks IEEE BBDITM students members, especially Srikant Singh, Marutandan Tripathi, Shivali Prasad, Avinash Gupta, for your diligence to conduct this program in the effective way. Again, thank you so much all.
Thank you, sir. I also thank all of you for joining us today. Thank you to our guests and thank you, audience, for being a very good audience today and being so, for engaging so much in this event. We will be back tomorrow with another session for you. It will be a technical webinar on by Dr. Chatterjee. So see you tomorrow. This the online segment for today's event is over. Now you all can leave. Thank you.